गोविंदम आदिपुरुषम तमहं भजामि। आदिपुरुषम द ओरिजिनल पर्सनैलिटी ऑफ गॉड। सो व्हेन वी स्पीक ऑफ गोविंदा, गोविंदा इज नॉट अलोन। इट्स लाइक व्हेन वी स्पीक ऑफ ए किंग, इट इज टू बी अंडरस्टूड दैट किंग इज नॉट अलोन। ही हैज गॉट मेनी अदर फॉलोअर्स, secretaries, ministers, soldiers, whole state. Similarly, when you speak of Govindam, behind Govinda, with Govinda, all living entities, all creation, everything, Govindam.
It is also wrong to consider that simply by becoming a vegetarian one can save himself from transgressing the laws of nature. Vegetables also have life. One life is meant to feed another living being, and that is the law of nature. One should not be proud of being a strict vegetarian. The point is to recognize the Supreme Lord. The animals have no developed consciousness to recognize the Lord. But a human being,
that is the main part. That's like there are the Buddhists, they are also vegetarian according to Buddhist principle. Nowadays everything has deteriorated, but Lord Buddha's propaganda was to make the rascals at least to stop animal killing. Ahimsa Paramo Dharma. Lord Buddha's appearance is described in the Srimad Bhagavatam and many Vedic literatures. Surat Bhishang, he came to cheat the demons. The demons, he made such a policy that the demons were cheated. How he was cheated? The demons, they are against God. They don't believe in God. So Lord Buddha propagated, yes, there is no God. But what I say, you follow. Yes, sir. But he is God. This is cheating. Yes. They do not believe in God, but they believe in Buddha, and Buddha is God. Keshava Dhita Buddha Sarira Jaya Jagadishare. So that is the difference between a demon and a devotee. A devotee sees that how Krishna Keshava is cheating these rascals. The devotee can understand. But the demons, they think, oh, we have got a nice leader. He does not believe in God. Is it? Sanmohaya Sruta Visham. The exact Sanskrit word is stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam. You have seen, those who have read. Sanmohaya for bewildering. Surat Visham. Surat Visham means persons who are envious of the Vaishnavas. The atheist class demons, they are always envious of the devotees. And that is the law of nature. You see, this father, a father became an enemy of a 5-year-old son. What was his fault? He was a devotee. That's innocent boy, simply he was, I want to say, attracted by chanting Hare Krishna mantra. The father himself became a staunch enemy, killed this boy. So if a father can become enemy, what to speak of others? So you should always expect that as soon as you become a devotee, the whole world becomes your enemy. That's all. But you have to deal with them. Because you are appointed servants of God, your mission is to enlighten them. So you cannot be just like Lord Nityananda, he was injured, but still he delivered Jagaimala. That should be your principle. Sometimes we have to cheat, sometimes we have to be injured, so many things. The only device is how people can become Krishna conscious. That is our mission. Somewhere or other, these rascals should be converted to Krishna consciousness. Either this way or that. So Lord Buddha, he cheated the demons. Why he cheated? Sadaya ridaya dari sita pasu ghatam. He was very compassionate. God is always sympathetic to all living entities because everyone is his son. So these rascals were killing unrestrictedly, simply animal killing. And if you say, oh, why are animal killing? They will immediately say, oh, it is in the Vedas, there is pasava, badhaya, srishtya. The animal killing is there in the Vedas. But what the purpose? That is to test the Vedic mantra. A animal will be put into the fire and by Vedic mantra he will be rejuvenated. That is sacrifice, animal sacrifice. Not that for eating purpose. Therefore, in this age of Kali, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has forbidden any kind of yoga because there is no, expert, a Brahmin, who can chant the mantras and make experiment of the Vedic mantras that here is coming out. That is, before performing yoga, how the mantra is potent, that was tested by sacrificing animal and again giving life. Then it is to be understood that the priests who are chanting that mantra, that is right. That was a test, not for animal killing. But these rascals, for eating animals, they cited here there is animal killing. Just like in Calcutta, you had been in Calcutta, and there is a street, College Street. Now it is differently named. I think it is named Vidhan Rai, just like. Anyway, so there are some slaughterhouses. So slaughterhouses means the Hindus, they do not purchase meat from Muslims' shop. That is impure. The same thing, stool this side and that side. They are eating meat and Hindu shop is pure, Muslim shop is impure. These are mental concoctions. Religion is going on like this, therefore fighting. I am Hindu, I am Muslim, I am Christian. Nobody knows religion. You see? They are giving up religion, these rascals. There is no religion. The real religion is this, Krishna consciousness, which teaches how to love God, that's all. That is religion. Any religion, it doesn't matter whether Hindu religion, Muslim religion, Christian religion, if you are developing love of God, then you are perfect in your religion. Otherwise, you are rascal, your religion is nonsense. That is the test. Savai pumsaparo dharma, jato bhakti radhokhaje. Ap ahaita ki apratihata, jayatma suprasidat. This is Bhagavad religion. That is first class religion. What is that? Jato, by executing the religious principles, if you develop your love for the Supreme, who is beyond expression of your words and beyond the activities of your mind. Adhokhaja. This very word is used, adhokhaja, where your material senses cannot approach. And what kind of that love? Ahituki. Without any cause. Oh love, I love you, God, because you supplying me so many nice things, your order supply. No, not that sort of love. Without any exchange, that is taught by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So whatever you do, aslisava padaratang finastama, either you trample me under your feet or you embrace me, whatever you like, you make me broken hearted by not seeing you, that doesn't matter. Still you are my worshipful Lord. That is love. From God's side, he may do whatever he likes. I don't want anything in exchange. That is love. That sort of love Krishna wants. Therefore he was so much fond of the gopis. If the gopi is love, there was no question of business preparing. Give me this, that then I love you. No. That is pure love. That is analog. Ahituki apratihata. Apratihata means without being checked. No impediment. If you want to love God, there is nothing throughout the whole world which can check you. Simply, you have to develop your eagerness. Krishna, I want you. That's all. Then there is no question of checking. In any condition, you will increase your love. And why this? Jayatma suprasidati. If you attain that state, then you will feel fully satisfied. Otherwise not. Otherwise. If you can develop your love for God or Krishna without being checked, without any cause, then you will feel fully satisfied. Otherwise not. It is for your interest. And God, it is not for God's interest that he wants you. It is for your interest. If you do otherwise, you will never be happy. This is the only way. Sarvadharmaan parityajyamami kangasara. Therefore, here it is stated, simply to become vegetarian is not the last word. There are many vegetarians. The monkey is vegetarian. He is naked and lives in a jungle, just like so many so-called sages, that I live naked, I live in the jungle, I have given up the society. So monkey is doing that? Naked, vegetarian, no home. But the rascal has got at least 2 dozen wives. That is monkey. So it is called Markat Vairagya. He has become a sannyasi, vairagi, and that so much thing, but privately he has got so many connections. That is called Markat Vairagya. Monkey's renunciation. Monkey has renounced, naked, but at heart there is sense gratification. So, Markat Vairagya is the good. But simply to become vegetarian is no good. You must develop love of God. That is the idea. Thank you.